Some said the time had finally come for Delta North to lead Delta State. Some said he was one of the founding fathers of the People's Democratic Party in the state. Others even said that no one had a more proven track record than he. Whatever the popular consensus, this is a man worthy of leading our dear state in the 21st century. This outstanding leader has demonstrated unparalleled excellence from his heydays at Edo College, where he graduated in 1976, and then proceeding to study medicine and surgery at the University of Ibadan, graduating in 1981 as a medical doctor. He will go on to give back to his fatherland, working with the now defunct Bendel State Hospital's Management Board as a medical officer. With a passion to give more to his people and be more hands-on with his patients, he embarked on private practice as director, Victory Medical Center Ibanke in 1986. Not satisfied with his contribution to his nation, this political colossus would veer into politics in 1991, becoming secretary to the Ika local government and then chairman of Ika North East Local Government Council between 1991 and 1993, a testament of his immense contributions to the masses within such a short period of time. A political strategist in every sense of the word, he joined the PDP in 1998, assisting former Governor James Ibori's campaign gain a sweeping victory in the 1999 Democratic elections. In recognition of his immense contribution, the government of the day would shoulder him with tremendous responsibilities. He would serve as Commissioner for Agriculture and Natural Resources, Commissioner for Water Resources Development, and Commissioner for Health over a seven-year period, demonstrating his versatility, ingenuity, and passion for service. A new government emerged in 2007, yet Dr. Okowa's unprecedented milestones would speak for him yet again. As he was appointed as secretary to the Delta State Government in 2007, he served amiably in this capacity for 3 years before resigning to contest the senatorial seat for Delta North. Being a grassroots politician, he gained victory in the 2011 elections. His presence in the Senate would bring outstanding, hitherto unimaginable projects to his people, such as the construction of the Otoebu Bridge in Oshimili North, linking Delta and Edo States, the construction of the 6.5-kilometer road in Imuda, Nasaba, electrification of some villages like Ebu, Agbonta, just to mention a few. Today, through the instrumentality of Senator Okowa, the Federal Medical Center Asaba has a new state-of-the-art gynecology orthopedic complex. Time will not allow us to expatiate on his countless achievements as a senator, as Delta North felt the presence of the federal government like never before. Considering his antecedents and effective style of leadership, who else could take over the reins of leadership in Delta State in 2015 other than this political stalwart and technocrat? He contested for the governorship ticket under a great party amidst stiff competition, emerging as its flag bearer and subsequently winning the governorship election by a landslide as Delta unanimously and overwhelmingly voted for him. Considering the drastic fall in oil prices, coupled with the recession our generation has been facing since 2015, Delta State needed a leader that could thrive in adversity. Commence the hour, commence the man. His Excellency Dr. Ifeanyi Arthur Okowa. Like the proverbial tsunami, he hit the ground running with a 5-point agenda aimed at revitalizing and renewing Delta State as the hub for infrastructural and human capital development. An agenda aimed at transforming Delta State holistically from the grassroots through strategic wealth creation and job provision for all Deltans, meaningful peace-building platforms to promote political and social harmony, agricultural reforms and accelerated industrialization, relevant health and education policies, and a transformed environment through urban renewal. His Excellency's smart agenda has not only set up the state on a high mark to battle the recession, but also make our dear state one of the leading economic powers in the nation. Despite the biting economy, internal generated revenue between June 2015 and September 2016 was 56.6 billion, representing a 68.53% performance, a result of our governor's dynamic and visionary leadership. Time will not allow us to elucidate and expound on Dr. Okowa's administration's milestones in just 2 years. Such as the creation of over 17,000 private sector jobs through schemes such as the Youth Agricultural Entrepreneurs Program, YAGE, Skills Training Entrepreneurship Program, STEP, Production and Processing Support Program, PPSP, as well as introducing the Graduate Employment Enhancement Program, GEP. The non-oil sector hasn't been more vibrant. The construction of not less than 71 road projects between May 2015 and November 2016, covering a distance of over 282 kilometers of roads and 138,000 kilometers of concrete line drain. Urban renewal is ever on the increase by working on several roads in strategic towns and cities across the state through rehabilitation, reconstruction, and construction, such as the 7.1 kilometer dualization of the Nnebisi Road, Asaba, dualization of Sapele Road from Amokwe to ATMP, reconstruction of the old Ole, Olomoro, Emede Road, amongst others. The agricultural sector is now thriving in the state because of His Excellency's vision to ensure food security through the empowerment of existing farmers and encouraging new entrants into agriculture through the Oil Palm Development Program. This is expected to empower 250 oil palm farmers, create 100 regular jobs and 300 seasonal jobs. The state government has approved huge sums to promote all-season rice farming, as well as the fishery subsector, where 5,000 youths have engaged themselves in aquaculture. The state government has also keyed into the CBN's Anchor Borrowers program to empower 30,000 farmers. What more can be said of a government with a vision for its people? Knowing that if any state is to compete with leading nations, its health sector must be ready at all times. And being a medical doctor by excellence, he has transformed the health sector of Delta State with both remodeling, renovation, and construction efforts in hospitals across the state, like the upgrading of the College Hospital Abavo, renovation of the Renal Dialysis Building Central Hospital Warri, procurement of 9 oxygen concentrators spread across the 3 senatorial districts of the state, and many more. Maternal mortality ratio is on the decline, a reflection of the success of the free under 5 healthcare program that this administration has not reneged on, in spite and despite limited resources due to the economic recession. Believing in the age-old truism that health is wealth, this administration is poised to implement the contributory health pension scheme, which will ensure universal health coverage for all categories of Deltans. Delta State is the very first to achieve this uncommon milestone. Education has been at the forefront of the SMART agenda, as the basic secondary and tertiary education has received tremendous support. Our great Delta State University, DELSU, has been undergoing a new wave of rehabilitative and new construction projects to make this great institution compete with leading universities in Nigeria. The State Bursary and Scholarship Board is also receiving great boost. Technical and vocational education now have a hope for the future, with the transmission of an executive bill to the Delta State House of Assembly to establish the Technical and Vocational Education Board, a move aimed at making Delta State the hub for industrial revolution in Nigeria. The upgrade of the Agbo of Agbe, Sapele, Eselu Uku, Ogo, and Tagbe Ogbe technical colleges are still ongoing. It has not been smooth sailing, as there have been challenges, there have been setbacks. But one thing is sure, the government of Delta State, under His Excellency's astute leadership, is working tirelessly with each passing day to ensure prosperity for all Deltans on all fronts. Ladies and gentlemen, in 2 years, Delta State has made steady, remarkable progress, and today our people are filled with hope that the coming years will only get better and better and better, all because of this political stalwart, a man of commitment and focus, a technocrat from a rare breed, a leader of outstanding perspicacity, a man of astounding versatility and ingenuity, and a leader with the political will to deliver on his promises to the people. We say 58 hearty cheers to you. Happy birthday, Your Excellency, Dr. Ifeanyi Arthur Okowa. God bless you and continue to keep you for the good people of Delta State.